This is Tom Bernacki, and today I'm going over spinal cord stimulators. This is something that I use a lot in my own private practice. Chronic pain, back pain, sciatica, neuropathy, diabetic neuropathy, chronic pain that just isn't getting better. There is a solution, and the results are pretty good. I'm gonna go over exactly how it works and what the studies are, and we're starting now. I make a lot of videos about peripheral neuropathy, back pain, sciatica, foot pain that's just not getting better. The majority of the time we can get people better, but sometimes it just does not get better. There's billions of people out in this world. There's millions and millions of people who can't sleep, who are in chronic pain, who can't taste their food because everything hurts, who can't get out of the house because everything hurts. If you get to this point and you've seen like 1, 2, 3 doctors, if no one's helping you, this is something you should start considering, because there are products for those types of patients that can work really good. In fact, about 8 or 9 people out of 10 on average see at least 50% relief with some of these well-rated products. What we're talking about specifically is high frequency spinal cord stimulation. This is a relatively new technology that a lot of people are not aware. This is considered to be the most advanced type of neuropathy treatment, back pain treatment. There's about 5 different major companies. I like to use one, which is Nevro, and these products are FDA approved. I have a video where I compare the 5 major companies, the pros and cons of each one. So if you're considering a spinal cord stimulator, check out that video, it's linked below. I talk about the pros and cons of every single one of these spinal cord stimulation devices. The Nevro spinal cord stimulator, spoiler alert, it's the one I use, so I think it's the best one personally. The reason why, it has a lot of good features. They've done prospective studies, so this means real world people, and I'm talking hundreds of people. They measure the complication rates, how many people had relief, how many had issues, how many it didn't work for, and they just publish all this data out to the world. So there's 4 major prospective studies that look at leg pain, back pain, neuropathy pain, diabetic neuropathy, and these control studies are actually really good with really good results. If surgery and meds didn't help, so for example, if you're on gabapentin, Lyrica, a lot of these pain control medications, the meds have gotten a bad rap lately. If the meds didn't help, this is actually a really good option, because the studies show that these implants did help better than the medications. And if surgery didn't help you, which, spoiler alert, it's not that effective, then these spinal cord stimulators can be very beneficial as well. When I look over the 4 major trials, on average, 8 out of 10 people had at least 50% relief. They basically put these stimulators on people, and if you had at least 50% relief, that was considered success. If you only had like 30 or 40% relief, that was considered a thumbs down. With chronic pain, your spinal cord shoots abnormal signals to your brain through your spinal cord. Basically, 2 little electrodes attached to your spine, and they have a high frequency signal that basically has your brain stop feeling these sensations. So as an example, when I did my fellowship training, I watched a surgeon who basically cuts open the nerves, and he looks at the nerves that control your muscles, so say like your fingers or your toes, and he stimulates those. If they move a finger or a toe, he leaves those alone, but if they don't do anything, it's actually a sensory nerve, and he can knock that out. So people could still move their hands and their feet, but they just don't really have feeling down to their toes as much as they did. That's kind of what the spinal cord stimulator does without going in and doing heavy duty surgery, cutting out your nerves. You can still walk, you can still move, you can still do everything, but the pain is gone. And you can control this with a remote. So kind of how I'm holding the remote here, you can control it when you go to bed, you can turn it up a little bit. When you're up and walking and it doesn't bother you as much, you don't have to turn it on necessarily. And the benefits of the high frequency stimulation is there's no paresthesia. That means is when you turn it on, with some of the low frequency devices, and I do that in my comparison video, it's kind of numb, it's a weird sensation, you can feel the vibrations, that's considered a paresthesia. But with the high frequencies, like 10,000 hertz, you don't necessarily feel that. If you come to Michigan, we work at a diabetes clinic and a podiatry clinic together, so we have 5 diabetic only specialists, and we have diabetic foot specialists for neuropathy, for example, we'd evaluate you and see if you're a good candidate, and we'd refer you to one of our pain management colleagues. And they would put the stimulator on your spine, on your back. It wouldn't be implanted all the way the first time, but they'd see how you do for about 7 to 10 days. If the majority of your pain disappears pretty quickly, hey, that's a pretty good deal. But if it doesn't disappear, then it's probably not the right product for you. The good news is 9 out of 10 people stick with it after the 7 to 10 day trial because it is effective. There's 2 thin insulated wires that actually get connected percutaneously to your back. And on the outside, you wear a rechargeable device. Now, you could put this little device under the skin. It's about the size of a cigarette lighter. Chargers for your Apple and Android devices where you just lay it on there. You can hold those up to your spine. It can recharge. It can last like 10 to 25 years in some cases. And this calms the spinal nerves. It's a quick, minimally invasive outpatient procedure. So within a couple hours, you're going home. There's a small little nick on your back. They could seal it up with glue or a couple stitches. Benefits are you could use it all day. You could use a remote. You could charge it. You could still get MRIs done. You could still go swimming. You could still go do a lot of stuff. You can still use the bathtub. You can pretty much resume your regular use as long as you're not getting punched in the back or doing some kind of crazy stuff where it really takes a lot of abuse. You should be fine. That helped. Watch all our videos on peripheral neuropathy, back pain, sciatica, and check out our videos comparing all these different devices. Let us know what you think. Did it help? Is it good? Bad experiences? Let us know. We love hearing so that we can make better videos. Thank you.